In pursuit of happiness, what is the limit to what you can do? Is it really alright to abandon our responsibilities to be happy? I'm Kathleen, and I'll be talking about Japanese film 誰も知らない, translating to Nobody Knows. Directed by Hirokazu Koreeda and released in 2004, Nobody Knows was based on a 1998 event. The Sugamo child abandonment case, in which a mother abandoned her 5 underage children. Similarly, in the film, single parent Kyōko abandons her 4 young children for a man who promises her a better life. The film begins with mother Kyōko and 12-year-old son Akira moving into their new apartment. However, Akira isn't the only child. Kyōko, Shigeru, and Yuki are snuck into their new house, stuffed in their luggage. Their mother, being afraid of getting evicted again, sets strict rules: no screaming or shouting, and no going outside other than Akira. They also do not attend school as their mother thinks it's a waste of time. Kyōko leaves them alone for a few weeks, then months, and eventually never returns. Without their mother, the 4 children are left to survive by themselves, depending on the eldest, Akira, to look after them. Nobody Knows was first shown at the 2004 Cannes Film Festival and won Best Actor. It also won Best Picture at the 29th Ho Chi Film Awards. Director Hirokazu, known for his heartfelt films, showed special attention to both mise-en-scène and cinematography in Nobody Knows. First, let me touch on mise-en-scène in the film. The plot occurs mostly in the same places throughout the film. Since the children are tied down to their house, it would make sense. These few places are their apartment, the grocery store, and the playground, in which the children eventually escape to when they leave the house together for the first time. The repeated mention of these places in the film helps the audience understand that the story is happening in one community or one neighborhood. It also reflects how the children are trapped in one space. The apartment in particular slowly becomes a huge mess with no one to clean the place and utilities cut off. Dirty laundry and rubbish are scattered on the floor towards the end of the film. Although subtle, the audience are able to tell the passage of time that has passed. This also allows us to understand the plight of the 4 children who are living in a state of despair, bringing pity and respect for the children. Another location that was constantly shown in the film was the grocery store. Koreeda cleverly uses the transition of Akira's actions in the store to show the gradual downfall of the children's life without their mother. Akira was first sabotaged by a few young teenagers, leading the store owner to believe that Akira stole from the store. Then, soon after, his friends dared him to steal from the same grocery store, in which he refused to. And lastly, he eventually stole from the store to help his sister. This gradual transition also feeds the general idea that the children are slowly changing from in need of assistance to just desperate to survive. Costume also played a huge part in the film. In the beginning, the children were shown wearing proper clothes. However, after their mother left them, their clothes started to become really visibly worn out. There were holes in their shirts and dirt on their face. It may not seem important, but it played a huge role in the story. The first scene of the film showed Akira in his already torn clothes with a luggage. Why would his clothes be already torn at this stage? In actual fact, the film started with the plot already ending, in which, spoiler alert, Yuki is already dead and Akira is on his way to bury her. Without his torn clothes and overgrown hair, as the audience, we would think that this scene was showing Akira on the train with his mother, traveling to their new apartment, since the face of the girl who was with him in the first scene was never shown. Now, let's move on to cinematography in the film. The first notable thing about Koreeda's shooting style in Nobody Knows is that there are many close-up shots of the children. This causes us to understand how the children are feeling, trapped. Not only in a literal sense, but metaphorically struggling to survive without an adult in the household. In contrast to this, when the children leave the apartment for the first time, long shots are used to represent the freedom that they feel for a short time. Instead of using mostly shots of the children themselves, Koreeda focused on the children's interests, habits, and actions. Movie critic Adam Campbell states, "One of Koreeda's great successes is to put the audience on a level with the children, not by overused devices such as dropping the camera to kid height, but focusing more on their interests, habits, and practices." Most shots in the film show the children's fingers touching things, subtly hinting at the underlying meaning. For example, Kyōko is shown fiddling with her toy piano and nail polish that her mother gave her. Both the opening scene and ending scene shows Akira touching the edges of the luggage, both with very different meanings. Low angles are used to portray intimidating characters, such as the grocery store owner when questioning Akira. Lighting was all natural in the film, creating a realistic depiction of the story. The filming style in Nobody Knows shows off beautiful moments of childish realism. Many applaud Koreeda for devoting vast amount of film to show the explorations and simple pleasures of these four children, at the same time showing their helplessness in their situation. Hirokazu once said, "I'm not interested in creating heroes, superheroes or anti-heroes," he said. "I simply want to look at people as they are." The last scene concludes the film in the most heartbreaking way. Saki's hand on Akira's, a touch that bridges the hole between their broken family and the universe, between childhood and adulthood for Akira, suggesting that the four children have managed to compromise through their difficulties and come out as a family, where adults have clearly failed them. Sure, their mother is portrayed as extremely childish and maybe even the metaphorical fifth child. The film covers pressing issues such as abandonment of children, scrutiny of one-parent families, and a generation who cares too much for themselves. The problem then lies not in the children who have tried their hardest to survive, but society who has allowed it to happen, but would rather not know.